Today we will be introducing three overhead allocation methods and looking at an example using the plant-wide rate. Let's first talk about why we need overhead allocation methods in the first place. For a variety of reasons, it's important for a manufacturer to know the cost of the products that they produce. One of the primary reasons accurate costing is needed is in order to set prices. For example, if I want to make $10 in gross profit per toaster that I sell, then that's easy if I know that the toaster costs me $30 to produce. I should charge $40. But if I don't have accurate cost information, or my cost data is bad or based on incomplete figures, I won't know what price to set. So how do we calculate the cost of a manufactured product? Well, we add up the three product costs, the direct materials, the direct labor, and the factory overhead that went into creating the product. The direct material and direct labor costs are usually easy to calculate. It's the factory overhead, the indirect manufacturing costs like rent or utilities that give us issues. It isn't that the factory overhead costs are hard to determine, it's just that we don't know how much of them should apply to different products. If you have one factory where you manufacture 8 different products, how would you determine what share of the factory rent should be allocated to each product? What about the wages of the supervisor who is responsible for workers on all 8 product lines? His or her wages should be part of the cost to create these products, but how much of the cost should go to each product? These are hard questions to answer, and there are many different approaches to answering them. There are 3 main approaches to allocating overhead to different products. First, we have the plant-wide overhead rate. This method relates all overhead costs to a single allocation base, such as direct labor hours. We discussed this method in the Introduction to Job Order Costing video. A second method is called the departmental overhead rate. This method first allocates overhead costs to each department and then allows us to use a different allocation base to allocate overhead for each department. So maybe in Department 1, the overhead is allocated based on labor hours, and then in Department 2, overhead is allocated based on machine hours. The third method is activity-based costing, which first allocates costs to activities and then allows for several different allocation bases for each activity to allocate overhead costs to products. So you might have 3 different activities per department, totaling for 6, 9, or even more than 10 overhead rates to allocate the overhead costs. The key thing to remember is the number of overhead rates used for each method. There is only one overhead rate for the plant-wide method, one per department, usually totaling for 2 or 3 in the departmental method, and as many as necessary for the activity-based cost method. Each method will result in a different factory overhead cost applied to each product. In theory, the activity-based costing should be the most accurate, as it uses the most information in determining the cost per unit. For the rest of this video, we're going to look at an example applying a plant-wide overhead rate, where we will calculate the total cost and profit for 2 products. In the next video, we will look at the same example and see how the costs and profit change when an activity-based approach is applied. Let's say that my company manufactures 2 toasters. The first one we call the basic toaster, which has nothing flashy but gets the job done. The second one we call the winged oven, which will fly your toast right to your table. It's equipped with state-of-the-art high-tech heating elements that will never burn your toast and always leave you satisfied. The direct materials are $20 per unit for the basic toaster and $35 each for the winged oven. The direct labor averages at $20 per hour for the basic toaster. However, only the most skilled craftsmen are allowed to work on the winged oven, making its direct labor cost per hour $28. It takes a quarter hour or 0.25 of an hour of direct labor to produce a basic toaster and half an hour or 0.5 of an hour to produce one winged oven. Now I've given you enough information to do what I call the easy part, calculating the direct material and direct labor costs. These costs are the same regardless of if you use the plant-wide, departmental, or activity-based costing, as those methods only apply to the overhead costs. For direct materials, there is no calculation necessary. We already know the direct material cost per toaster, which is typical. It's pretty easy to track the materials that went directly into producing the toaster. For direct labor, we need to do a little bit more work. We know the direct labor rates per hour, but we want the dollar amount per unit, or per toaster, since the toaster is our cost object. If we look at the basic toaster, we can take the $20 direct labor cost per hour and multiply by the 0.25 hours per unit required to make the toaster. The hours will cancel out, and we are left with the direct labor cost per unit of $5. We can apply the same process to the winged oven and get a direct labor cost per unit of $14. So now we have our direct material and direct labor cost per unit. Remember these numbers as we will come back to them when we find the total product cost per unit. All we need is the factory overhead cost now. First, we will look at a plant-wide overhead rate, and then, as already mentioned, we will apply activity-based costing in the next video and compare the differences. For the plant-wide overhead rate, we are going to use the allocation base of machine hours. Let's say that 5,000 basic toasters and 2,500 winged ovens are produced in a month. The basic toaster uses 150 machine hours per month, and the winged oven uses 350 machine hours per month, making for a total of 500 machine hours. Also, assume that the total overhead costs for the month are $117,000. These are the overhead costs that we need to assign to each of the two products. We can find the plant-wide overhead rate by taking the estimated overhead costs and dividing by the estimated activity base, which is machine hours in our case. For simplicity, we will assume that the actual machine hours and overhead costs are equal to the estimated amount. Otherwise, we might end up with some over or under applied overhead, which is a situation we addressed in the job order costing videos. So we have $117,000 divided by 500 machine hours, which gives us $234 of overhead costs to apply for each machine hour used. Next, we can find the overhead applied for each product by taking the overhead cost per machine hour multiplied by the number of machine hours for each product. Starting with the basic toaster, we have $234 times 150 machine hours, which equals $35,100 total basic toaster overhead costs. And for the winged oven, we have $234 multiplied by 350 equals $81,900. Now we can find the overhead cost per unit by taking the total overhead cost allocated to each product and dividing by the number of toasters produced. So $35,100 divided by 5,000 basic toasters equals $7.02 of overhead cost per basic toaster, and $81,900 divided by 2,500 winged ovens equals $32.76 of overhead cost per winged oven. Warning! Overhead costs per unit can be misleading. Many overhead costs don't change with volume. So producing one additional winged oven does not necessarily mean that the company will incur an additional $32.76 of overhead costs, especially if that overhead cost includes things like rent, which are clearly fixed costs. Just think of this number as the amount of overhead allocated per unit for the current production volume. Okay, we are almost done. The only thing left to do is to calculate the total cost per unit, which means we have to add up the three product costs: the direct materials, direct labor, and the factory overhead. Remember that for the basic toaster, the direct material cost was given at $20 per unit, the direct labor cost was calculated to be $5 per unit, and we just calculated the overhead to be $7.02 per unit. For the winged oven, the direct material cost was $35 per unit, the direct labor was calculated to be $14 per unit, and the factory overhead cost we just calculated to be $32.76 per unit. Adding up the per unit costs gives us a total cost per unit of $32.02 for the basic toaster and $81.76 for the winged oven. Let's say that the price per basic toaster is $45. That means that we can find the per unit profit by taking the $45 price and subtracting the $32.02 cost per unit, giving us a $12.98 gross profit per unit. Let's say that we sell the winged oven for $75 each. $75 minus the $81.76 cost gives us negative $6.76 in gross profit per unit. Yes, according to the plant-wide overhead rate, this company is actually losing money on the winged oven. If we want, we can also calculate the total profit by taking the profit per unit and multiplying by the number of units sold. You may remember that we sold 5,000 basic toasters and 2,500 winged ovens. $12.98 times the 5,000 basic toasters gives us $64,900 in total profit for the basic toasters, and negative $6.76 multiplied by the 2,500 winged ovens gives us negative $16,900 in total profit for the winged ovens. We could also rephrase this as a $16,900 loss on the winged ovens. We can calculate the total profit, which is $64,900 minus $16,900, which gives us $48,000. Note that this total profit value will be the same regardless of what costing method that you use, whether it be the plant-wide rate, a departmental rate, or an activity-based rate. So now that we've done all of this work, let's consider the question. If the winged oven is unprofitable, does that mean we should stop producing it? Well, not necessarily, and there are many reasons why. Just look at the overhead cost for the winged oven. It's $32.76, compared to only $7.02 per unit for the basic toaster. If we were to stop producing the winged oven, many of these overhead costs would have to be absorbed by the basic toaster, making it less profitable. The second thing to question is how accurately the overhead cost was allocated based on the plant-wide rate using machine hours. You may remember that the winged oven is a lot more machine-intensive than the basic toaster, using 350 hours compared to the basic toaster's 150, causing large amounts of overhead to be assigned to the winged oven. That's okay if the machine hours are closely related to overhead costs, but overhead is typically more complicated than that. If we were to use a more detailed approach that uses more information, including multiple overhead rates, we might be able to assign a more accurate overhead cost that could result in the winged oven being more profitable. That more detailed approach I'm referring to is called activity-based costing. We'll explore how to apply this method to our example in the next video.